Welcome to another new video where I want to talk about the Sony Xperia 1 Mark III and the news that I saw on a Chinese unboxing video and first quick test. So what we saw on this video is first of all that we will have a new basic camera application, and all I want to talk about in this video is this basic camera application and how it works. And I show you also some sample pictures with some of my analysis, early analysis of the footage that we can see on the Xperia 1 Mark III. So let's get started. First of all, I have to say thank you for all those feedbacks and great comments that I got on my last video about the Xperia 1 Mark III. It's just a couple of days ago, actually yesterday, I think. And thank you also for the feedback of the microphone that I'm using here, the new Sony ECM-W2BT. There will be, the unboxing will come, especially as so many requested me to do an unboxing as well. And of course, I fixed the audio problem where it was a little bit, overdriving the microphone a bit. There's a little switch that you can switch to minus 10 or minus 20 dB. I have set it to minus 20 dB right now. That fits better if you have this microphone so close to your mouth. Anyway, what I want to talk about is the Sony camera application on the Xperia 1 Mark III. We have a new review, a Chinese review, where we can see clearly how this UI will look like and how it is integrated into the Photo Pro app. So basically, you know the Photo Pro app, and the top left corner has the mode option where you can switch to the auto mode, or you can switch to the P, to the S, to the A, and to the M mode. Wait a second, there's no A mode, but to the PSM mode. And these mode switches now have a new option called Basic, and this is where we find the new Basic UI for the Photo Pro mode. So for the Photo Pro app, for the photo app in this case, I would say, because it has a Pro app and it has a basic app as well. So this basic app allows you to switch between the different camera lenses. We now also know the magnification of those camera lenses. So we have a 0.7 times ultra wide angle, then the 1 times, then we have a tele, which the tele is 2.9 times, so almost 3 times. And then we have the 4.4 times tele. That is this variable periscope zoom that can go up to 12.3 times, I think. But this is then, I think, also a magnification which is using digital zoom. So I'm not quite sure, maybe you can do the math and write it down in the comment section, what the Taylor 105mm sensor should be, or the photo length in terms of Sony terms for the times magnification. Anyway, so this is what you can see there. We can see also clearly again the option also in the photo app in the basic mode to record video. I don't think you have an option to record 4K 60 frames per second again. That would be a little bit awkward to go to the Cinema Pro app again for having this slow motion effect. And the Cinema Pro app, by the way, also shown quickly in the review, nothing basically has changed there. So the main focus is on the new camera application that has all the new and great features. What we can see also in this little review are some sample shots, and we can see the usual things and suspects, or the usual processing of Sony cameras, just like on my Xperia 1 Mark II that I'm recording this with here. We have the same kind of color signs going on. So what we will see there is that there's a comparison between the iPhone, Samsung and the Sony, and what we can see clearly is Sony has the more natural colors. The iPhone is a little bit overexposed, it has a little bit boosted colors and very strong HDR effect, and Samsung is also very strong on HDR but also very strong and boosted colors, and Sony has the most natural colors. That means in regards of HDR, high dynamic range, Sony has less HDR or dramatic HDR effects. So what you will get if you see a shadow, you will get the shadow also on the Sony app. On the others, you can see that it's slightly brighten up a bit. Then what we can also see is nighttime mode. Nighttime pictures are also typical Sony nighttime pictures. So they don't try like iPhone or Samsung to make a daylight shot out of the nighttime, what they do is simply capture the nighttime shot, so you get darker exposures. What I like in this example is you can see the background is not overexposed, so they have this in control a little bit, so the background is not not overexposed, and the bike in front is a little bit too dark in comparison to the other ones, but the other ones have a little bit too bright in background, I would say. So I think Sony makes their own, they do their own thing there with the night mode, and this might be not for everyone's taste, but I think I like it, so it's more realistic to what normal cameras would produce in this situation. Then we have also, and this is one of the major facts and major points of this Sony camera, and I'm glad that someone was testing it out in this way, sports and action, because with the new camera sensors on the Xperia 1 Mark III and all of them having the possibility to shoot fast burst shots even for quick sports and action, it makes a lot of sense to test it out. And of course we already know the main sensor, 20 frames per second with autofocus, with auto exposure, with eye autofocus even, great. But what about the zoom camera and the ultrawide? They are also been improved, and I think especially the zoom camera now has the possibility also to track with 10 frames per second with eye autofocus. I think, no, not eye autofocus, but at least face tracking is there. That what I saw in the video. So we can see in the video, what we see in the video, I've just grabbed some screenshots, is that there was some basketball game going on, and the reviewer was reviewing the was comparing the Samsung S1, the Galaxy S21, against the Xperia when it comes to taking shots, photos of those basketball players in action. And what you clearly can see is with the slightly zoomed in Samsung, it is impossible to get a clear shot. Like 80% of those shots are not sharp. On the other hand, 80% of the shots with the Xperia are sharp. So the complete difference, a complete opposite in this case, because it has this good eye tracking, it has this good face tracking, and also object tracking, so it can tap also of one of the players and it will try to keep them in focus. And because of the 10 frames per second, you can also get pretty good shots, like sports shots, where you can see one player jumping and moving with the basketball, which is also pretty nice. And this is one of the big features that was missing in smartphones. You had to have DSLM cameras with maybe also large lenses, and of course very expensive. Think about the Sony Alpha A9 or Sony Alpha 9, Sony Alpha 1, very expensive cameras to get this quick burst shots with autofocus for sports and life and action. And this is now possible with a smartphone. This is mind-blowing, I would say, because it is something that we never had before. And this is where Sony's focus is mainly. It's not so much who has the better, the biggest, the more times zoom, like Samsung comes with 100 times zoom and now Xiaomi comes with 120 times zoom. It's not about this. It's about getting good shots out of your device. So even if you only have like 12 times zoom or 10 times zoom, it should be still good enough for a nice shot. And then of course, so they're not overdoing it there, and then of course it should have the option to have like all the features of the main sensor as much as possible, like this quick action shots where you can take those action shots. Doesn't help so much if you have doing stills photography or you're in a zoo, if corona times allow you to go to the zoo, and want to take a snapshot of a nice lion or something like this. Lions are mostly still, but if the lion has some action because someone throwing some meat and feed time or something like this, and he's jumping, and you have the option now with your smartphone to get a nice shot of this as well. I think this is pretty amazing, I would say. A few years ago, it wouldn't be possible. And it's interesting because no one else is doing it. Everyone else is in the megapixel race, like 108 megapixel sensors and high dynamic range and zoom like crazy. And maybe ultra wides now like crazy, and a little bit of video as well. Sony always was good in video. You can see this video here, Xperia 1 Mark II. Two, not three. The video is pretty good. The autofocus is pretty good as well. I think even better than the Xperia 5 Mark II, which constantly lost my face. And this one is at least focusing on my face, I think. And yeah, I'm really, really happy with the Xperia 1 Mark III and how it's coming together. And what they're focusing on is something unique no one else is doing. And this makes it very interesting, and it makes it like in another league almost. It's not so far away where you can see it's like obscure features, just like LG was doing some radar sensor vein recognition. It is still in the same ballpark, but it's doing something different. In a way so much different that it makes it interesting, I think, for photographers who want to leave their DSLR, or even like I'm thinking about the RX100 Mark something or the ZV-1. You don't need it if you have an Xperia phone. I'm using the Xperia 1 Mark II here because you get this nice bokeh effect still with the main lens, not so nice as maybe the ZV-1, and maybe not so much the flexibility of zooming in and zooming out, but you have the possibility to do a nice vlog, you have the possibility to get a nice shot with the main lens, and with Xperia 1 Mark III, you get even more flexibility with this nice zoom lens that I think could beat and make the ZV-1 or RX100 series obsolete. Granted, it's a smaller sensor also for the zooming, so especially in low light you will get better, more professional-like images with those. But when computational photography is getting better and better also for Sony's, and they get the night photography maybe right, and the sensors are getting better for less noise as well, I think this would be very, very good technology and a very, very good indeed replacement for such small little cameras. What do you think? Write it down in the comment section. That is basically everything for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have some other leaks and some other comments and some other videos that you want to share, just write them down in the comment section as well. Or just write an email maybe if you're not sure to write it publicly. And that's everything for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Until the next time. Bye.